Phil Elwood from the San Francisco Examiner, June 16, 1996.
In a profession famed for personal and professional excesses, Miss Fitzgerald was the rock of stability. A non-smoker and non-drinker, fascinated to the end by new songs and singers. Years ago, she commented that other than a tisket a tasket, her most important recording event came when Grands encouraged her to record the Cole Porter Songbook in 1955. "I've always thought of myself as a ballad singer," Miss Fitzgerald said, "and that series of songbooks was a big turning point in my career." After the Porter set, she sang sets devoted to Gershwin, Berlin, Rodgers and Hart, Harold Arlen, Duke Ellington, and others.
Beautifully produced and packaged, they displayed her vocal skills, gave her magnificent accompaniments, arrangers and soloists, and gained her a whole new audience. Frank Sinatra called her the best singer in the world. Bing Crosby said, "She's the greatest." Her gorgeous voice, her consistency, her musicality and integrity conquered increasingly large concert audiences around the world.
Ms. Fitzgerald was nervous and fidgety before a show and often was unsettled during the first couple of tunes. "Oh, thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to sing some older ones for you tonight and a few new ones, and I hope you like them," she'd say in her girlish speaking voice.
Every musician who worked with her felt honored. Every musician who heard her held a special place in their hearts for Ms. Fitzgerald.
Her audiences got more out of her songs because she put more into them.
Ella Fitzgerald is a great philanthropist. She gives so generously of her talent, not only to the public, but to the composers whose works she performs. Her artistry always brings to mind the words of the maestro, Mr. Toscanini, who said, "There are only two kinds of musicians. Either you're a good musician or you're not." And in terms of musicianship, Ella Fitzgerald is beyond category.
If you asked Ella a personal question, "What are your thoughts, your feelings? Where are your parents? Where's your past?"
she might scat,
"Ba-wee, ba-da-da-dee-dee-da-da-da-wee." But she would not likely give you a straight answer.
What you learned about Ella, you got from swing, mood, tone, color,
lemon drop, cherry red,
honeysuckle rose. Very occasionally,
she might sing a downhearted blues. Her final years were blinding years. She lived a sugarfoot rag. Glaucoma haunted her, but it did not daunt her. Her eyesight diminished, her weight diminished, her legs disappeared, her life dwindled. She retired to her home rather than to be publicly awash in the last blue truth.
Ella lilted and ran all across the 20th century to fame, to riches,
to a not silent now. She was as dependable as a metronome and had much more complex timing.
Virtually no other singer was so
sliding and so accurate at the same time.
Her ooh-ooh-ba-doo-wa riffed and called all at once. A hug full of music-loving nerves was what you got from her. High notes.
Scat notes. Love me, never leave me notes. Ella courted the world that way.
And she won all the love there was. She was alluring, if aloof.
She was effusive, though not confessional. What she did was swing and scat and dare the melodies with all the cats. Ella hid behind her music,
became herself a song. She was much ado about invention.
Much excitement about voice.
Ella was clarity
and melody and daring
in a private lyric soul.